Have you ever wanted to analyze conversations, transcripts, tweets, or other type of text data? Well, that is possible with the deal that I'm going to be talking about. It's called DeepTalk, and it reads that information and you can analyze it to later use. Now, this not might be for everyone, but after watching this video, you might understand what it does and you can see if it's something that's useful for you. So let's go check out the deal and check out DeepTalk. So let's head on over to my desktop. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $69 for the lifetime deal. And if you guys want to grab it, that link will be provided in the description. I would thank you a lot if you use that link because it helps me out to make these videos. Now, this is an alternative to Monkey Learn, Shattermill, and Amazon Comprehend. Let me show you what that deal actually gets you really quickly. Let's go down here. So license tier one, which is $69 for the lifetime deal, gets you 100,000 rows of data per month. Now, you're going to be saying to yourself, well, what is a row? Let's just say that we upload a CSV. Each one of those rows would be considered a row. So when you are talking about a conversation, those are going to be added by row, and it reads those rows. So that's how this license tier works. If you need more rows, well, license tier 2, license tier 3, and you can jump up to license tier 4. But all the features, you're going to get them with the same license tier 1 as license tier 4. It's just going to change what the amount of rows are gonna allow you per month, okay? Now, let's go jump over to DeepTalk, okay? This is my dashboard for DeepTalk, and I've uploaded four of these projects, and one is a demo project, which is a conversations from Obama, which is political. That could be a use case where you want to analyze what this politician has been saying for an amount of time, so you can understand how many times they use the word, if you want to analyze it with other type of words, and just find out what that does. Another use case is this one, Elon Musk, which I uploaded the tweets, and I'll be opening these two, don't worry about it. And you can understand what he's been talking about on his tweets for the amount of X time, right? So it's kind of analyzing the text data. And another one is WP Funnels, which is a video that I uploaded, and I did a transcribe on it. So I converted it into text, and then I uploaded it right here. Let's get started with the first one, which is this demo project from Obama. And I'm going to open it up. And first of all, we're going to be greeted with the summary, which is the project name, the model name, number of analyzed elements, 536. And then we have a word cloud, which we can find what he's been talking most of. Okay. We have topics by table. So for example, vote has been used the most, 85 times. The fraction of it is 15.9%. No keywords on it. I can view the actions for this, like see the topic in details. I can change the topic name and go see the subtopics. But we can see what type of words this person has been using for whatever X reason you might need that information for. So in this case, politicians, well, you might want to know, like how many times did he say banner, freedom, vote, war, or whatever. And you get those analysts right here. On the topics, we're able to view a sunburst. So on the sunburst, we're able to view like what type of topics has he been talking about, but a kind of nice looking chart. If I click on any of these, I'll be able to view, for example, election. I'll click on it and we'll get subtopics for it. There's 25 elements. We can see what else he's been talking about. For example, root, vote, election, job bidding, day, and people on this one. And we get on the right, we get the topic name, the auto-generated name, depth, member count, all that information, word cloud for that, topic members, where this has been mentioned, so you can check these out. We also have the topic table on the left, the time evolution, like when did he talk about this? Depending, for example, if you upload a text data with a date range, well, you're going to view this time evolution. If it's just one go, like for example, the transcript from my video, well, there's no time evolution. It's just one conversation, okay? Includes media links, so no and yes, and the percentage for that. We can create groups for this. For example, if I want to create a group based on this and that, I can do it by adding a group and I can view them on the end, okay? I can reload the chart. I can view other type of things right here. Check it out. I can download topic assignments, select a date range for this. Again, if you have a date range for it, I can choose from here also instead of using the sunburst and clicking on it, I can choose right there, choose a topic, for example, vote, election, and other type of topics with it, okay? There's also discovery for this. In this case, there's a date range again. I can click on it, I can search for it. Search, well, it's probably, there we go. Reload the chart. Discovery should show me those. Okay, I'll check it out on another one of these uploads. The trends for this, for example, if I'm doing the trends for this, which is family, vote, and Michelle Obama, and it's viewing how this person has mentioned that name during this trend right here. So vote was mentioned a lot on October. That's probably because it was election time. So you kind of understand the idea of how you can use this in terms of politics, okay? For the groups, in this case, there's no groups created for this. Let's go back into workspace, dashboard. Let's go check out Elon Musk. In this case, what I'm using is a use case for tweets, right? You're checking out tweets and you wanna know what he talks most about, right? So here's the topics for this. And he's mentioned, for example, Tesla, Dojo, video, model, SpaceX, for example, if you wanna check out SpaceX, and SpaceX with space. And I can create a group for that. Create a new group, space. There we go, that group has been added. Let's go check out that group right here. So here's SpaceX, I have that group created right here. And we have the info based on that and the time evolution for it. Again, I'm also gonna be able to view it here on the trends. So I'll get rid of good and I'll mention Tesla. Let me get those topics over there. I'll send them over to topic trend. There we go, now I've added SpaceX to the trend and I can view how many times he's been talking about that. So maybe I'm not interested in Tesla, but I'm interested in SpaceX. So you can see the evolution from those tweets, how many times he has mentioned it. And you can understand that maybe he's interested in this or not, or maybe he's talking less about it and he's talking more about other parts of his company. And you would understand, I don't know, maybe you want to invest on his company. Well, it's a good idea or a bad idea, and you analyze that information. All of this is based for analysts, okay? Discovery for this, again, you got the date range, you got the groups that you can create, you can view the groups topics right there, and that's how you would use it. Go back to the dashboard. This is one of my videos, WP Funnels, which I uploaded the conversation, no particular reason at all, but just you get an idea. For example, I uploaded this video, and right off the bat, I know it's about funnels. I know it's about license, sell, upsell, choose a plugin. And you can view just by looking at the word cloud what this conversation is about. If you got a random conversation and you put it in here, you'll understand what it's about. For example, I've mentioned all these times these words right there. The topics of this conversation, the discovery, right? In this case, there is no date range. It was just one-off upload because it's just one day. The trends for it, if I'm talking about deal, steps, and plugins, you have it there. Again, no date range for this. And groups, if I wanted to create one, that is possible. Whoops, clicked on it twice. And it gave me a 500 error, so be aware of that. Let's go back. Let's go back into the dashboard. But that is how that works. Now, what if you want to upload something? Well, you'll go into create a new project, you'll name it, and I'll just say test for video 2. I'll create it, no description for now. I can have the option as of now to do it via intercom, do it via the integration. That's the only one that's available right now, but they will be adding more. And via CSV, which is the way I've been doing it. The text data, was it conversations or was it general text data? In this case, it was a general text data. Text cluster, test, submit. I'll choose my file. For example, I deleted it already. But you choose the file, you upload it, and it's gonna select, you have to tie the columns with the option that it has. For example, if it's a conversation, well, you tie it to the column where the conversations had been done. For example, for the Elon Musk, it was the tweets. So that was a column for it on the conversation and the date range. It'll ask you for each one of these, and it's pretty much straightforward, okay, to add them. You have the results for it. No model for it. The API is not available. It's coming soon. I'm not sure if that's going to be added in the AppSumo deal, but I think it's for corporate only, but we'll have to check for that. I'll reply in the comments once I have an answer for it. There's task. If you want to create a task for it, Pending tasks, none has been created. No running task. The integrations, like I mentioned before, right now only intercom is available. And for the settings, well, I just have my information for the amount of usage I have used for this. I have the one code, 100,000 words. That might be enough for most of us, but maybe some people might need more if you have a lot of text that you want to input here, a lot of rows. So in this case, I've used 24,592 rows with these workspaces I've been playing around with. So it was the Obama one, Elon Musk, and three tests for videos. That's the amount of words, rows I've been using. And the projects, there seems to be no limitation. You can add as many as you want. The limitations come with the rows. But that is for DeepTalk. That's what it actually does. And it will depend on what you actually need it for. If this is something that you might need to analyze text, conversations, tweets, transcripts, or something like that, this could be a really good use case. Or for example, for people who are in the movie business and they want to see the transcript for the movie, this could be really useful because you want to know what it's been talking most about and what is it for. Now, things I would like to see are, for example, sentiment for the rows in case you want to use this for something else. Let's just say it's tied to intercom and you want to get a sentiment for each one of those rows. Like, was that person angry? Was it happy? And those are the kind of things that I would like to see. But basically, that is what it does, DeepTalk. And like I mentioned before, the lifetime deal link will be provided in the description in case you want to grab it. Well, I thank y'all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.